One, you want to tackle your collections in the way that's going to benefit you the most on your credit report and your credit score. You want to do that. And then two, you want to tackle the collections in a strategic way where it'll actually benefit you financially as well. So we're going to get into both of these. So tackle them strategically. If you have a collection that's, say, 6 years old, so you got a collection that's 6 years old and it's a significant amount. So I won't throw out an amount because significant to some people is, you know, you might have a $400 collection and that's significant to you because of what you have in terms of income. You could have a collection that's $6,000, and so that's going to be significant. So I won't throw out a number. Let's say it's significant to you and it's 6 years old. Well, you know, because you've been listening to the 800 Credit Score Man show for so long, that that collection is going to stay on your credit report for 7 years, maybe 7 years and 180 days. So that's 7.5 years. But you're 6 years in right now, and it's a significant amount, an amount that you don't necessarily have. So what are you going to do with that one? So do just because you're starting to try to restore your credit, and depending on where your score is, this could take a year to get done. A lot of people think it can get done all the time in 3 months or 6 months. Not necessarily so. Depends on your situation. So if it can take a year to get done on that particular collection that's 6 years old and a significant amount of money, you may want to just let it ride. You may want to let it ride and let it fall off your credit report in 7 years or so. And I also say to you that you should Google and look up to see what the statute of limitations is in your particular state about collections. Because if you haven't heard from these people in a while, and especially if you haven't heard from them in a while, and you have multiple collections, you might want to just go ahead and let this one slide. But Googling your particular state and seeing what the statute of limitations is, and that's how long that someone can collect on you for a particular debt. So it may be different if they may be able to collect on you for 4 years for, you know, a simple debt like a cable bill or what have you, and that's why you haven't heard from them, even though it still stays on your credit report for 7 years. So that's what one of the reasons I'm saying strategically. You've got to look at that. So you might want to let that one go ahead and just fall by the wayside and take your lumps, if you will, for the next year. You've already done it for 6 years, so it's going to be coming off your credit report in a relatively short period of time. Who knew that 2018 was going to be here so quick, right? So that's how you got to think about that one. If you need some specific advice on your collections or anything credit related, please give me a call or shoot me an email at 800creditscoreman@gmail.com. Shoot me an email there. So let's go ahead and let's talk about this one. Now, if you have a medical collection, what are you going to do? So if you got a medical collection, and even if you've got more than one, you got 4 or 5 different medical collections from the same incident or from several incidents after that, you didn't pay that $40 deductible somewhere, and now it's on your credit report, or that ambulance ride that was $500 to $800 and you couldn't pay it, but you had to pay it, or that x-ray or whatever it is. What you want to do is when you look at all of your collections and you got some medical, you got one from a cable company, got one from, you know, from a cell phone company, what you want to do is you want to tackle the medical collections first, especially if they aren't huge amounts of money. You want to attack the medical collections first. Now, why do I say you attack the medical collections first? Here's why. You're going to attack the medical collections first because once you pay the medical collection, whether it comes off of your credit report or not, it's going to no longer be a factor in your score. So listen to me. This is medical collections only. So if you have a medical collection, and let's just say it's $100, you pay that medical collection and say it's the only collection you have on your credit report. It has pulled your credit report down 70, 80 points. When you pay that medical collection and it's reflected on your credit report, then the TransUnion, Equifax, Experian, they are no longer going to factor that in. Even if it's still on your credit report, it shows paid. As long as it shows paid, they're no longer going to factor that in. So if that's the only thing that you have out there outstanding, your credit report and your credit score should actually soar when it comes to that. So medical collections are the things that you want to attack first when it comes to your collections. All right, you guys, so we're past the halfway point, and you know we got to do the question of the day. So we're going to jump into the question of the day, and I'm going to give another shout out. I got a shout out Chuck Hughes Jr. Happy birthday to you, Chuck Hughes Jr. And let me give this shout out to Brody Milburn. Brody Milburn, member of Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated, the Alpha Chapter. This is actually my pledge father. So happy, happy birthday to you, Brody Milburn. Haven't talked to you in a minute because you've been over there hanging out with Putin, and I don't need that kind of trouble. But happy birthday to you, Brody Milburn. So let's jump into the question of the day. So the question of the day actually is sponsored by who else? No one other than Cute as a Cupcake, Cupcakery and Bake Shop, where the cupcakes are more than just cute, they're delicious. Cute as a Cupcake is located at 2008 West 81st in Merrillville, Indiana. Get by there and tell them that Cute is that the 800 credit score man sent you. And look, check this out. So I've been telling you how good these cupcakes are, and I don't know if you believe me or not, but delish.com actually rated Cute as a Cupcake the best cupcakes in all of Indiana. So if you are in the Merrillville area anywhere, or you going through, you live in Indianapolis, you live in Evansville, you live in Fort Wayne, and you're going through Merrillville, Indiana, trying to get to Chicago for the holidays or whatever it is, you need to make a stop at 2008 West 81st and get by Cute as a Cupcake. I'm telling you, you're going to thank me. All right, so let's get into this question. So the question is from Jody, and I don't know where Jody is from. I sent him a text late, right before the show started, to see where he's from. So this question is from Jody. You know, if I don't know where you're from, I like to make up someplace. So I'm going to say Jody, and let's say Jody is from New Mexico. So thanks, Jody, for contacting me. I truly appreciate it. And Jody's question is this: is bankruptcy included in the new arrangement that started on July the 1st, 2017? Thank you. All right, so look, what Jody is referring to, let me give you a little background right quick. So on July the 1st, 2017, the credit bureaus, TransUnion, Equifax, and Experian, made an arrangement that was sparked by Eric Schneiderman. He is the attorney general out of New York. This man has done a lot over the last year and a half, 2 years, in regards to consumers to help us all out and your credit reports. So in this arrangement, the credit bureaus are no longer putting on your credit report tax liens, whether they're state or federal, and they're no longer putting judgments on your report. So in Jody's questions, is bankruptcy included in this? Unfortunately, no. Bankruptcy is not included in this. So if you have a bankruptcy, had one in the past, or what have you, that's going to stay on your credit report for the 10 years or the 7 years or whatever it is going to be for you. So that's going to stay on your credit report if it's a bankruptcy. However, if you have any other judgments at all, it should have come off already, because now we're in December. So they rolled it out slowly. Some came off right away. And this means not only new judgments and tax liens, but also old judgments and tax liens. So as of right now, in December 2017, you still have them on your credit report. You need to contact that particular credit agency. So from my experience and what I've heard and what I've seen, some of the, well, not even some, one, and I'm going to go ahead and throw TransUnion under the bus right here. TransUnion has been tripping a little bit about taking some of these off of your credit report. It should have already been done. It should have been automatic. You didn't have to do anything to get it done. But TransUnion has been the one that I've seen that has had some issues trying to get these off of your credit report. So if you still have any on your credit report, doesn't matter which credit agency it's from, you need to contact that agency and just simply let them know that, hey, you know, far as you're concerned, July the 1st, 2017, this should no longer be on your credit report, and you need them to have to remove that. So that's where we're going on with that. So look, this is my favorite part of the entire show, is the question of the day, because I get questions from people all of the time, and I love it when people specifically write me and say, hey, I got a question, and hopefully you'll use it on the show. So you go ahead and you write me at 800creditscoreman@gmail.com. Send me your question. I will answer your question directly to you, and then I may use you on the show as well as the question of the day. So, Jody, Welcome to the 800 Credit Score Man Show family. You are officially a part of this particular family. So thank you so very much. Please keep listening and share this show. And everybody out there, contact me, 800creditscoreman@gmail.com. All right, let's get back into the show, you guys, before we get out of here. All right, so look, so we're talking about tips today and things that will help you improve your credit score overall. Before I get to finish the tip that we were just talking about, let me give a shout out to Valencia Frazier. She is celebrating her birthday coming up this week. So I want to say happy, happy birthday to you, Valencia, a great woman of God. She goes to Living Purpose Church in Aurora, Illinois. So you guys get by Living Purpose Church as well to check them out with the pastor, Tim Bailey there. So Valencia Frazier, happy, happy early birthday to you. And I got to give a shout out to this guy. This is actually one of my sayings. So I celebrated my 24th anniversary in Kappa Alpha Psi Fraternity Incorporated in 14 nights. So I gave us a shout the 14 nights a week or so ago. And Reggie White. So Reggie White's birthday is Tuesday. This is the rock of my line. And you got to say it like this, Reggie White. So happy, happy birthday to you, Reggie. Man, I will see you next weekend. I definitely see you next weekend. So I'm looking forward to that. All right, so let's get back into this whole collections thing. So the first thing you want to tackle, like I said, was you want to tackle those medical bills. You want to make sure you pay those. And when you're doing so, when you're contacting these people for your medical bills, oftentimes they do not like to reduce the amount that you owe. So if you owe somebody $800 to hospital or $1,000 or whatever, typically they don't like to reduce the amount. You know, it's just a different, it's a different thing than when you have a cable bill or a cell phone bill. So they don't like to reduce the amount often, but they will sometimes. So some of the places will give you a couple options. They'll say, we can reduce it for you by a certain percentage, but we won't take it off your credit report. So now, since that's not an issue for you, because even if you want your credit report to look pretty, then ask them to take it off your credit report and do it that way. But since it's not going to count against you once you pay this medical bill, it's best for you and your pocket to go ahead and take the percentage off. So some places will give you as much as 20% off. Totally, totally different than when if you have one from, you know, any old other company. If you got one from Finger Hut, a collection from Finger Hut, you might get Finger Hut to take 50% off that particular collection. But when it comes to medical, you may not be able to do that. So if you get 20% off, then take it and run. All right, take it and run. Go ahead, pay it off. It's going to help your score because they're no longer will be factored against you. So make sure that you tackle those first. And it's nothing wrong with asking. Always ask for a reduction in whatever amount you owe any of these people when it comes to collections. You want to ask for that reduction, even if it's medical. Let them tell you, nope, we can't do that. We can only do 20%, or we can only do 15%, or whatever it is, but make sure that you ask. Now, moving on to other collections. In other collections, then, you know, so if you got an old cell phone bill, a utility bill, cable bill, or whatever, then you want to call them too when you're ready to pay. So when you're actually ready to pay, you want to give them a call. If you're not, if there's no hurry, then wait and do it strategically. I say call them at the end of a quarter or at the end of the year. So March, June, September, December, that's when you want to give them a call. Collection agencies get bonuses too. So they may be willing to work with you simply because it's the end of their bonus period. So throw out what you want to give them. So like, and I'm talking about like a ridiculous low number. Throw out a ridiculous low number. So for example, if you owe somebody $999, tell them you'll give them $300 to settle the debt and you want to remove from your credit report. Now they might laugh at you, but so what? You gotta ask. You gotta ask for that reduction. So they may counter and say, nah, we'll do $700. Now, if that's the case, basically, you already saved yourself $300. Already saved yourself $300 by simply asking instead of just go ahead and paying them. Now, I wouldn't even accept that when they come back and say, you know, $700. I wouldn't not counter again. So then maybe I would offer $450. And if they agree to that, look at how much you just saved yourself. You just saved yourself. And more importantly, you got this particular collection removed off of your credit report, and you saved yourself $550. So you